YouTube. I'm Always Blazing here, back with another video. Today is going to be another strain review. So sit back, get your joints out, get your bongs out, get your vapes out, and enjoy the video, guys. So let's jump right into the strain review. For review today, we actually have some Cornbread. Now, what is Cornbread? Cornbread is a indica strain, and I'm gonna give you the lineage of Cornbread, which is honestly an amazing lineage. Some of my favorite strains are actually in the lineage of Cornbread, so I am really, really excited to make this review for you guys. So the lineage of Cornbread is actually a Katsu Bubba Kush and a Rare Dankness number 2. Now you guys are probably wondering, okay, what is Rare Dankness and what is Katsu Bubba Kush? So Bubba Kush, or the Katsu Bubba Kush, actually is just a phenotype of Bubba Kush. So it has apparently a very floral terpene profile. And the Rare Dankness number 2, which is an amazing, amazing strain that I've actually never tried before, is a Ghost OG crossed with Chem Dog. Then they got that cross and they back crossed it to Ghost OG again. Once they finished that off, they got that cross and crossed it to a Triangle Kush. So in the lineage of this Cornbread, you have Bubba Kush, you have a Chem Dog, you have a Ghost OG, and you also have, what was the last one? Triangle Kush. So you have Kushes in there, you have OGs in there, you have Chem Dog in there. I mean, this is gonna be an amazing strain. I've been smoking this a lot already, and this has to be one of my new favorite strains. So as I was saying already, guys, this is definitely one of my newer favorite strains. Shout out to Rare Dankness for breeding this amazing cultivar Cornbread, and thank you to Coastal Wildfire for providing this amazing cannabis. So without further ado, I'm gonna pause the video, I'm gonna flip the camera around, and we're gonna take a look at these beautiful Cornbread nugs. So stick around and stay tuned, guys. Guys, we are back and we are taking a look at these beautiful nugs of Cornbread. I mean, this is some of the nicest cannabis I've seen in a while. The bud structure, the trichome coverage, the density of the nugs, the size of the nugs, the colors, the smell, everything on this strain is on point. I mean, it is just beautiful cannabis. Like, it is just spectacular. I mean, the amount of trichomes that are covering this nug is just insane. It's all trichome heads. They're all intact. The buds haven't been squished. They haven't been manhandled. I mean, Coastal Wildfire absolutely killed this Cornbread. I cannot say enough about it. I mean, it is just some beautiful, beautiful looking stuff here. Let me try and zoom in. Hopefully it'll focus, but like, oh my goodness, like, look at this bud. It is just insanity, absolute insanity, just beautiful nugs. Let me show you another one here. Just absolutely amazing. You could just see the trichomes everywhere. Yeah, just, I mean, I can't say enough about it. This stuff looks amazing. It has kind of like a dark kind of green color to it. with a lot of orange hairs. The bud structure is very dense. As I was saying, the bud structure is just very dense, very like compact, lots of trichome coverage, and there's a little bit of purple hues in there, but oh my god, this is some beautiful looking stuff. I am going to flip the camera back around. We are going to take a look, or actually we're going to give you the smell of the cornbread, and we're going to finish off this review. So stick around and stay tuned for the rest of the video, guys. All right, we are back, guys. So I showed you guys what the cornbread looks like, and oh my god, it is some beautiful, beautiful looking cannabis. I haven't seen stuff that looked like this in a long, long time. Let's jump right into the smell of this cornbread. And I'm gonna pull out a nug right here and just kind of break it up a little bit. But first, let me take a whiff of the entire jar. Wow. So right off the bat, I would say this reminds me a lot of OG Kush. It has a very piney kind of incense earthiness, if that makes sense. I mean, there's a lot of different strains in here. There's Kushes, there's Bubba Kush. Well, sorry, there's Triangle Kush, there's Bubba Kush, there's Chem Dog, there's Ghost OG. So there's a lot of different attributes kind of coming together as one. But let me give you a more accurate smell profile. Give me a sec here. I'm just gonna crack open this nug. Okay, so once you actually kind of crack open the nug, you know, break it up a little bit, get those like trichomes kind of broken up and the smell kind of coming through, it has a slight lemon zest in there. So if you were to kind of like cut a lemon peel and kind of smell that, it has a slight lemon zest in there, very piney, very earthy. It has like an incense kind of smell to it. What else am I getting here? It also, if you've had Bubba Kush before, it also has a slight sweetness from the Bubba Kush that kind of comes through. So it's a very unique and complex terpene profile. It has that sweetness, kind of Bubba Kush kind of smell with a little bit of lemon zest and a lot of piney, earthy incense kind of notes to it. So it is very reminiscent of Bubba Kush, very reminiscent of OG. I can definitely see the spicy, incense-y kind of cushiness coming through. The one thing that doesn't come through really is the Chem Dog. I mean, when they were breeding the strain, they might have bred it to get maybe the Chem Dog bud structure versus getting the Chem Dog flavor. I don't know exactly what they did, or you know, if what females and what males were used, but this definitely reminds me of just an old school kick-ass OG kind of Bubba Kush kind of smell. I'm gonna wrap it all up for you guys. It's a sweet lemon zest. There's like that slight lemony kind of smell with a lot of piney, earthy incense type of notes. So that's for the smell. I gave you guys the looks, I gave you guys the smell. Obviously the next step is to bust this stuff up in the grinder, and we are gonna vape this at 365 degrees to start, and we're gonna go through there, and I'm gonna let you guys know how it tastes, how the effects are, and just how I'm feeling in general. So hopefully you guys have been enjoying the review so far. If you have, definitely drop a thumbs up. And yeah, stick around for the rest of the review, guys. Peace. All right, guys, we are back. I have the vape heated up back to 365 because I realized it actually did its auto shut off, and I wanted to make sure it was obviously at the right temperature before we started vaping. So that is ready to go. I have the cornbread broken up here in the grinder. I'm gonna give you guys a second kind of smell, just because when you break up certain strains, sometimes the smell changes a little bit. So let me give you the rest of the smell and we are gonna start vaping. So let's get right into the smell, guys. Oh, wow. So when you break up the nug, the terpenes and the smell just kind of like it gets more pungent and more loud and more like just in your face. When you kind of crack open the jar, it does have a very nice smell to it, but it's not one of those strains that is like super dank and super loud where it's gonna like just smell up the whole room. When I first got it too, and it was still really, it was still really fresh, it was the same kind of idea. Very pungent kind of terpene and smell, but not very loud, not very like, it won't fill up the room, if that makes sense. But the smell I'm getting off this is, wow. So the pininess and the earthiness just comes through even more. You get a lot more of that lemon kind of zestiness as well. And the other thing that comes through a lot more is that spiciness from the Kush strains, from the Triangle Kush and the Bubba Kush. It has a lot more of that like spicy kind of nostril tingly type of smell. But yeah, that's enough for the smell. I'm gonna get this vape bowl loaded up here, guys, and we are gonna start vaping right away. Just a heads up, I don't wanna spoil it for you guys. I'm gonna wait till I actually start vaping to give you guys what the effects are and how I'm feeling and stuff, because just a disclaimer, this stuff is some potent cannabis. Like, I have not come across a strain like this in a long, long time. This is a very unique, very well done, like from the breeding to whoever grew it, obviously Coastal Wildfire grew it, but from the beginning to the end, this is a top-notch strain. Like, this is a must-try for every cannabis user. I'm gonna shut up. Let's get this vape bowl going. If I didn't say it already, what are you guys smoking on? What are you guys dabbing on? Another thing I just forgot is, guys, we just hit 14,000 subscribers. Like, are you kidding me? That is insane. That is blowing my mind. Every time I check my phone, I check my YouTube notifications, I always see like the numbers just kind of jumping up. And I just wanted to say thank you to all the new subscribers. Thank you to all the old subscribers that have been here since day one. Thank you to all the people who comment on every video and who are positive and give feedback and just say nice things in the comments. There's a lot of haters. There's a lot of people that talk shit in the comments. Obviously, I don't focus on them. I don't focus my energy on them. I would rather reply to people who have questions, who are, you know, giving me advice or constructive criticism or just being positive and, you know, thanking me for the videos and whatnot. So thank you to everyone. I wouldn't be doing this and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you guys watching. I mean, if no one ever watched my videos, I mean, what's the point of really making them, right? So I'm glad you guys enjoy them. I'm glad you guys are getting, you know, some valuable information from my videos. And I'm glad to help everyone out who has questions as well. So thank you guys so much for 14,000 subscribers. Let me know if you're a new subscriber. Where are you from? What are you smoking on? What are you dabbing on? What are you vaping on? So always love to know. Comment down below. And yeah, let's get this vape bowl going, guys. So cheers. Hopefully you guys are joining along with me. Another thing I just wanted to say is I want to start making a lot more outdoor videos, maybe even vlog kind of style videos of maybe going downtown and showing you different places and showing you around the city and stuff like that. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys want to see vlog style videos or if you guys like the reviews better. I'm just kind of trying to get a feel of what you guys want to see. As of recently, actually, the weather here in Toronto has actually been horrible. What I mean by that is from the beginning of April to now, which is like May 18th, which is when I'm filming this video, for the last month and a half has literally been nonstop rain, overcast skies, cloudiness, cool weather. I mean, usually in May, by mid to end of May, we're hitting like 20 degree days, 25 degree weather. Today is literally like only 15 degrees and it's like cold and windy outside and it's cloudy. It's just like absolutely depressing. If you guys are from Toronto, if you guys are local from the GTA area, you guys definitely know what I'm talking about. So I really hope this is a good summer. I really hope we have some good weather because I want to make some more outdoor videos for sure. I'm going to shut up. Let's start vaping, guys. If you guys are new to the channel as well, and you guys have no clue what the hell this thing is or what the hell I'm doing right now, definitely check out my Volcano review and demo. It is on my channel, and you guys, I explain everything about this unit, how it works, and yeah, this has been my go-to as of recently for, you know, consuming cannabis, and I honestly think it's amazing. Saves me so much weed, saves your lungs, I just feel so much better, but the flavor of this cornbread, it just reminds me of an old school OG, like, you know, one of those old school strains where you just smoke it and you're just stuck in the couch, just high as a kite and just sedated. And that's what this reminds me of, just an old school kick-ass OG kush. That's the best way I can describe it. I'll give you a little bit more complex flavor that I'm getting. This is just the first vape bag, so usually the first vape bag is a lot of water vapor and just kind of flavor. Usually the second one is a little bit more dense, thicker vapor with a lot more flavor. So give me a sec, I'm going to finish this bag and we're going to go in on number two. Okay. So for the flavor of this cornbread, I am getting a very, very sweet lemon zest with a lot of piney, earthy, incense-y spiciness. I know a lot of people make fun of me, the words I use to describe the strains. I'll use words like vanilla-y, doughy, stuff like that, and people always make fun of me in the comments below, but that's just the best way I can describe it for you guys. Sweet lemon zest, very piney, very earthy, very incense-like smell and taste, and it has a spiciness as well. I love this strain. I mean, it's not the best tasting strain. It's not like it tastes like a dessert or like a fruit or anything crazy, but I just love old school kind of OG, cushy, bubba, sweet. Like, it's amazing. It's honestly just amazing. I'm gonna shut up again because I feel like when I get a strain I really like, I tend to ramble and talk a lot about it just because I really enjoy it. So I'm going to try and shut up, and we're going to go in on the second bag at 365 degrees. So let's do it, guys. All right. So just as a heads up for you guys, I know I haven't been uploading that frequently, that consistently. Reason is I actually got offered a full-time position at work, so I've been working full-time. I don't have days off really throughout the week to, you know, sit down in my room, quiet, no one's home, to make these type of videos for you guys. So content on the channel might slow down just a little bit, but I am definitely still grinding. I still love making videos for you guys. I still love, you know, explain to you guys and showcasing you guys new strains, new products. Like, it's just something I really do enjoy, and I'm definitely going to continue doing it. As I was saying before, guys, I still love making videos for you guys. I mean, it is a hobby. I love cannabis. I love showing you guys new products. I love showing you guys new strains, showcasing new growers, and just, it's just something I really enjoy doing. Just as a side note, before this edit, you guys will see that the temperature was at 365. Now it's at 375. I actually was filming for like an extra like 10 minutes past my cutoff time on my phone because there's like a 10 minute timer. So half of the stuff I was talking about didn't actually get recorded. So I'm kind of like backtracking now. But let's finish this review because I'm kind of backtracking now, so I kind of have to remember what I said and all those good points I brought across the first time I filmed this. The taste, I'm pretty sure I already gave that to you guys. I'm gonna start hitting this vape bag. But as I was saying, like, the lineage of this strain is just so amazing. You got Kushes, you got OGs, you got Chem Dogs. I mean, what more could you really ask for? I mean, the flavor might not be my favorite. It might not taste like a fruit or a dessert or anything crazy exotic like that. But it's very sweet. It's got the lemon zest. It has a very pronounced piney earthiness with like an incense kind of spiciness thrown in there as well. And it's just a potent, heavy strain. I'm going to give you guys the effects now. I mean, when you inhale it right off the bat, it just expands your lungs. Then when you exhale the vapor or the smoke, it just crushes your lungs. Like, it just grabs them like a vice grip and just like that. Like, you can just feel your chest just... Like, it's one of those strains you have to take a deep breath almost after just to get oxygen in your lungs. It is a heavy, heavy hitter. Whether you're, I'm assuming if you're dabbing it on concentrates, it'll probably be the same thing, probably even more pronounced. But if you're vaping it or you're smoking it, it is a heavy, heavy hitter. I'm gonna continue on this vape bag at 375. So right away, you feel it slowly come on. It starts behind the eyes. It makes your eyes very, very heavy. Not only that, it trickles down your neck into your spine, and it has like a very tingly, kind of like warm, fuzzy feeling that it gives you. Not only that, you kind of feel like a bobblehead. Like, you're kind of just like, your neck is very loose and your head kind of feels like very heavy almost. So it's got that bobblehead kind of feeling to it as well. Not only that, I mean, you could just fall asleep on this strain instantly. If you're a medical patient and you're looking for appetite stimulant, something to put you to sleep, something to even kind of uplift your mood slightly, I mean, this is an 80-20 indica to sativa strain, but they classify it as an indica strain. They don't call it really a hybrid. So, I mean, I'm talkative. I kind of have like a clear mind, but at the same time, it is a very sedative and very heavy strain. Very, like, the medicinal properties of this strain are very pronounced. I mean, if you lie down right now, you will almost feel like you're floating because you just have a tingly, warm, fuzzy sensation just going through your entire body. But at the same time, you have like those slight mood lifting properties where you're happy. You don't have any depression. You don't have any anxiety, but it's just very clear minded at the same time. And I'm somewhat talkative right now, which is very odd for an indica strain. But I mean, the effects of this cornbread are top notch, very potent, very hard hitting, very long lasting effects. I mean, I don't know what more I can really say. It is just an all around a fantastic strain. Rare Dankness, you guys did an amazing, amazing job on this cornbread. I mean, you can't ask for better lineage. You can't ask for better effects, better potency. Just, I mean, when I get a strain I really like, I cannot say enough about it. And this is one of them. This is definitely one of my new favorite strains. And yeah, shout out to Coastal Wildfire. Shout out to Rare Dankness for breeding this amazing cultivar. I'm going to give you guys the ratings out of 10 in just a second. I'm going to finish this vape bag first. So give me one sec, guys. All right, guys, I am back and I'm going to give you guys the ratings out of 10 for this cornbread. I mean, as you guys seen in the video, it is an amazing, amazing strain. I can't say enough about it. For the looks, I mean, just a beautiful, beautiful looking bud. Like, the nug structure is just very, very OG slash chem reminiscent. There's even like, maybe even a bubba too. I mean, the buds are just thick, chunky nugs, tight bud structure. I mean, looks like it was an easy trim because the trim job on it is amazing, but the trichome coverage on it is just insane. But at the same time, like, it's not one of those newer hype strains. For example, I don't know, let's just say peanut butter breath, where they look very, very frosty, but when you examine them under a microscope, they don't have that many trichome heads. It's mostly a lot of just stalk, if that makes sense. And if you were to look at this cornbread under a microscope, I mean, all you see is just bright glistening trichome heads everywhere. And you guys will see the videos and the pictures at the end. It's just beautiful. It's amazing. The looks of this for me is a solid 5 out of 5. Like, I couldn't ask for a better looking, better trimmed bud. Like, it's beautiful to look at. So that's a 5 out of 5 for looks on the cornbread. For the smell, like I said, is a very sweet kind of lemon zest with a lot of piney, earthy incense and spiciness. I mean, it's not my favorite smelling strain. It's not the loudest strain either. It's not like it's gonna fill up your room, but it does have a very pronounced terpene profile, which is very nice. I'm gonna have to give the smell a solid, the smell's gonna be a 3.5 out of 5. I mean, it's not my favorite smelling strain. It is nice, but I feel like it could be maybe a little bit better. It could be a little bit louder. Could be maybe even if they had like a different pheno, a more lemony pheno, like that would be a little bit nicer. But just in general, I would say the taste is about a 3.5. Or no, sorry, the smell is a 3.5. We're gonna go on to the taste right now. The taste, like I said before, comes through exactly like the smell, which is very good. But at the same time, like I said, it's not my favorite smelling strain, but it's also not my favorite tasting strain either. I mean, I do love the genetics. I love a good OG, and that's what it reminds me of. I mean, I wish it had a little bit more chem dog attributes in there for the smell wise and taste. But like I said, it just reminds me of a very, very good OG Kush, or a very, maybe Bubba, or even you kind of even get a triangle Kush kind of taste in there as well. So like, I mean, it just reminds you of a good old school OG. That's basically the best way I can describe it taste wise. So for the taste, I mean, I'm gonna also give it a 3.5 out of 5. I mean, this, when it comes to taste and the smell and me giving it a rating, it's based on my personal opinion and what I like. If someone likes the smell of OG, likes the smell of a Kush, that mixed together, this is gonna be a solid 5 out of 5 for smell. Like, it is a very nice smelling strain. That leads me to the effects though. Give me one sec. So the effects of this cornbread, 5 out of 5, no questions asked. If you need to sleep, if you need an appetite stimulant, if you just want to sit on the couch and watch a movie for an hour and then go to sleep, this is the strain for you. If you're a medicinal patient and you use cannabis for medicinal reasons medically, and you need a potent, long-lasting, heavy sedative strain, this is the one you want to get. Cornbread, this is amazing. Literally some top-notch medicinal stuff. You can use it recreationally, but you won't really be able to enjoy the effects because, like I said, you'll just fall asleep. It's that heavy. Very tingly, very sedative, kind of bobblehead, old school, like just stoned, sedative, OG kind of high. I mean, it's amazing. So that's a 5 out of 5. That's for the effects. The overall rating for the cornbread is gonna have to be a solid 4.5 out of 5. Yeah, 4.5 out of 5. Just because, I mean, the taste and the smell is not my favorite. It is very good though. It is very unique in the sense of you're getting a nice blend of Kush and OG kind of flavors mixed together in one, in the smell and taste. So if you're interested in that, I mean, this is some top-notch stuff. But that's the reason why it's getting a 4.5. The looks, the effects on this strain is what is beautiful and amazing and just what makes this strain what it is. I mean, it's fantastic. I give it 2 thumbs up. Highly recommend you guys try cornbread if you come across it. This has been the official review of Cornbread by I'm Always Blazing. Shout out to Coastal Wildfire. Shout out to Rare Dankness. And if you guys enjoyed the video, drop a thumbs up, comment, like, and subscribe if you're new. And we will see you guys in the next video. So stay tuned, guys. Peace.
Stop.